Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Welcome, welcome. Today I am bringing you this video about Ghanaians traveling outside the country, and it's crazy. Listen, the number of Ghanaians that are traveling outside, especially when you go to the airport, the departure, the people that are traveling outside the country is just crazy. People are just going like that. Why is it so? We all know. In this country, Ghana, when it comes to condition of services for government workers, the politicians sit on a lot of things. Instead of them, like, even the question is, how much is their salary? How much is their salary? How much? Some of them will be paid 2,000, 2,500, 3,000 maximum, nurses. And this nurse will be going to work day in, day out. They have to rent, they have to pay bills, they have to eat, they have to pick a car, transportation. Like, bro, imagine if the government even has bungalows for nurses and for doctors. Teachers, for instance, they have, even for teachers, I learned some of them even take 1,500, 1,800, not 1,500, like, seriously? Bro, why won't these people go? This is my question. Why won't these people go? Bro, we know, day in, day out, they increase fuel, prices of goods and services also goes up each and every time. But salary remains where it is. Why won't people go? And those two who are not nurses and who are also not teachers, they are all in this system and they are suffering. So if I will travel abroad and get a better job, a better paying job, I will not say a better job, because sometimes when they go, some of the jobs that they do, the menial jobs, sometimes when they are here, they will not even do these jobs. But the thing is, those jobs that they will not do here, when they go abroad and they are doing it, they get paid well. That's why all these people are going. That's why all these people are going. Let's watch this video.
Hey, people are traveling home. Kutuka International Airport. Hey, people are traveling on Kutuka International Airport.
This video, how many people, like, look at the number of people at the airport. Listen, I personally went and escorted one of my clients. She was going to the UK recently, not long ago, and that very day when I got there, bro, the departure, the number of people that were there, Christ, listen, a lot of people were at the airport. And you will ask yourself, why are all these people traveling? What is happening in the country? Like, what is the problem? Why, you know, Ghana is one of the countries that for me personally, I always say that if you have money, like a stable job that you get paid well, Ghana is one of the best place that you can ever live. Trust me. I think one thing that we are lacking behind is our roads. But apart from that, if you have money in this country, listen, even foreigners come and they are like, Charlie, Ghana is one of the best countries. But the thing is, if you are living in a country like this and you don't have a well-paid job or a well-paying job, and like the money that you are receiving, you just pay your rent, pay your bills, and that's it. It's difficult for you to be happy, to for you to also save money and say you want to do something, or even once in a while say you want to go on vacation or build property, do something for yourself. It's very difficult. It's very, very difficult. It's sad seeing all these people traveling outside to go and work and help another person's economy. And we are here. And we are here. These people have created jobs in their countries, and our citizens are even going there to work. Why can't we do the same thing here? Why can't we do the same thing here? You just don't understand. Why are we doing this to ourselves? The politicians, is like they don't care. Recently, you guys saw the protest.
These are the fellow Ghanaians and people that we are beyond age. This lady is beyond age. This is the real situation in the country. Now, you are seeing it. So if any media is asking a question, the student is asking, why are we here? These are the reason why we are here.
Come on, come on, come on.
Demonstrations going on. We are not okay in this country. If you are a foreigner and you come in with your dollars or with your pounds and your euros, for you, you will be happy because, Charlie, that money, if you change it to cedis, it's a lot of money. And you can spend it and live the life that you want to live. But what of we, the citizenry? Someone can work for somebody and the whole month, the person will be paid 600 Ghana cedis, 500 Ghana cedis. Serious. Can you survive with that money? Let's be honest with ourselves and just do something to help the country. It's sad. Very, very, very sad. Today, someone was saying that today, eh? If we are saying, oh, we don't want to, like, blacks are saying, the whites are racist, they are this, they are that, they are that, they are that. But trust me, slavery is over. Slavery is over. But today, as I'm speaking to you, if the white man brings the slave ship back to Africa, that they are going to take slaves or people from Africa back to the US and the and Europe and all these places, I'm telling you, the number of Africans that will board that ship, I'm telling you, if they bring that ship here and they say everybody should just go free, they're not going to even torture and do anything.
People are traveling on,
bro. You know the number
to cut international airports.
That ship. You know the number of Africans that will board that ship. It's crazy. This is the situation in Africa and Ghana. It's sad. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.